If you're following along, you'll know that a guy named Emmanuel tried to scam me, if that is his real name. He sent me a bad check and tried to get me to cash it and wire the money to his moving company. Well, I uncovered his plot, and now I'm gonna try to win him over to my side. Have you ever read Les Misérables by Victor Hugo? It's about a guy named Jean Valjean who tries to rob a bishop of his silver, but he's caught by the police and brought back to face him. But the bishop tells the police that Valjean didn't steal the silver, but that they were given to him as a gift. He even says, "Hey, by the way, you forgot the candlesticks." And the police are shocked, and Valjean is shocked, and the bishop says to Valjean to use the silver to become an honest man.
An honest man.
Which Valjean does, and he becomes a hero, and it's just the greatest story ever told. And that would have been really cool if Emmanuel took me up on my offer and turned his life around and did the same thing as Valjean. But as soon as I asked him where he really lived, he went dark and deleted his Google Voice number.
We're sorry.
So that was fun. But I thought, this is like fishing. And even though that fish got away, there were plenty more in the sea. So I set the bait. I created an ad for an iPad that I didn't even own. And I even said in the description that I accepted certified checks. And I could even ship it internationally. No scammer could resist. So now we sit and we wait. So a day went by and sure enough, I got a text asking if the iPad was still available. And this text sounded strikingly familiar. It said, "Is your item still available? Can I pay via certified checks? Text me at 707-346. This was clearly another scammer who wanted to send me another fake check. I mean, do people really fall for these things? But I decided to see how this one would play out and how far I could string this guy along. So I texted the number and I said, "My item is still available." He said, "Can I pay via certified check like I stated?" I said, "Yes." He said, "What's your final price?" $550. He said, "I'm okay with it. I will wait for the check to clear before coming for the item. Can I have the full name and mailing address to mail the check to?" It's the exact same strategy. So I gave him my P.O. box number, the same P.O. box number that I gave the last guy. And immediately he said, "You again? This Emmanuel." Are you kidding me? What are the chances that Emmanuel would stumble into me twice? I said, "Hey Emmanuel, long time no talk. Are you gonna send me a fake check again or do you wanna make money my way?" He said, "What's your way?" Now, I'm not entirely sure what I'm gonna have him do, but I said, "I have a large and growing online business and I need someone with your skills. What city are you in?" He said, "I'm in California. I hope you are not trying to catch me." "No, never, you can't." Wow, this guy needs to chill, but he is from California just like I suspected. He was just sending bogus checks from some random bank in Texas. Pretty clever. I said, "I'm not interested in catching you." He said, "If you want me to know you're serious, send an iTunes card of $100. Then I will know you are serious." Now, I was not about to drop $100 on a guy who's just tried to rip me off twice. So I decided to haggle with him a little bit. I said, "How about $25? He said, "Okay, send that." "Okay, I'll buy it and text you when I have it." He said, "How soon?" And I said, "Tomorrow." "I will be very pained if I find out you are giving me fake hopes. If you are fooling me, you need to stop here." This guy sounds nervous, but I try to reassure him. I said, "When I send you the gift card, you will know there is no fooling." He said, "Okay, we see." So the next day I went shopping to get this guy an iTunes gift card, and I cannot figure out why he wants an iTunes gift card so bad. Does he have some kind of Candy Crush addiction or something? I said, "I have the gift card. What address should I mail it to?" He said, "Hello, scratch and send me the gift card. Let the picture show the four edges of the card and it should show the codes clearly." So I took the card and I scratched it and I snapped the picture for him. I said, "Okay, I'm going to send it to you now to show you I'm serious. There will be an opportunity to make more if you work with me." He said, "Are you sure this is a valid card? Send me more pictures of the card before I try it on my phone." And I'm thinking, how many ways is there to take a picture of a card? But I do it anyway. I even sent him the receipt. He said, "Did you send me a real card? Be sincere. I don't want to try a bad card." Hello? This guy is paranoid. He thinks that I'm gonna send him a Trojan horse or something. I said, "Yes, I showed you the receipt to prove it. Now scan it and claim your money. This better be real." I said, "Well, you just scan it?" Wow, It worked. I'm ready to work.